Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting. We're talking about capital investments and net present value. And today we're going to be looking at a question requiring us to determine net present value and other rates of return. So my disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of myself and not my employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College in the South Orange County Community College District. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2024 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. Presentations from time to time use information from third parties or the third party information. Third party information is the property of those respective copyright holders, and the author does not make any claim to the third party information. Okay. So let's go ahead and take a look at our question for today. So we've got Too Many Business Clubs, Inc. decides to purchase equipment that will cost $800,000 will last 5 years. The equipment will have a salvage value of $500,000. Each year, TMBCI estimates the equipment will generate the following revenues. We got expenses, and then we're asked to go through and fill in everything. So let's go ahead and let's fill in the blanks. So the first one is basically complete the empty blanks above. First thing we need to figure out is depreciation. So basically, we can assume that the depreciation will be done using straight line. So coming over here, the first thing we have to do is figure out what our depreciation expense is. So the formula for depreciation is acquisition cost minus the salvage value divided by the estimated useful life. The equipment will cost $800,000. Salvage value is $50,000. And the estimated useful life is going to be 5 years. So this is going to be $750 divided by 5, or this will be $150,000 per year. So this is our formula for depreciation expense. Again, acquisition cost minus salvage value divided by the estimated useful life. And there we go. Okay. So have this part done right over here. So my depreciation expense is $150,000. Now my total expenses are going to be the 20 plus the 120 plus the 80 plus the 150 or $370,000. My net income before income taxes is going to be $500,000 minus $370 or $130,000. My income taxes are going to be 30% times $130,000. So my net income after tax is going to be $91,000. Now, I have filled in the blanks. The next thing I'm going to have to go through and do, and again, when you look at this, right, so this is A1, A2, A3, A4, total expenses are B is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. Net income before income taxes is going to be my revenues minus my total expenses. The income taxes are going to be the C times the 30% or D. And then my net income after tax is C minus D equals E. So this is, we've completed the empty blanks. What is the annual net cash flow? Now, if I was doing this just in terms of cash flow, the thing you have to remember is when we record depreciation expense, I'm debiting depreciation expense and I'm crediting accumulated depreciation on that equipment. And so this is when I'm talking about cash flow, the depreciation is going to be a non-cash item. So my total expenses in terms of cash flow are going to be not 370, but 220. My net income before income taxes is going to be 280. For cash purposes, I'm allowed a deduction for depreciation. So my net income after tax is going to be $241,000, or this is my net cash flow. Now, obviously, this seems like to be like a little bit of work. But the reason why I wanted to show you this is so that you know the shortcut. The shortcut for net cash flow is I'm going to add back the depreciation expense to my net income after tax, or I get 150. And so my net cash flow is going to be 241,000. So again, when we look at this from a bigger picture perspective, right, I could go through and compute net cash flow by eliminating, right, this over here, and I get to net cash flow. Or the easier way I can go through and do this is just to add back the depreciation expense to my net income. Let's go ahead and take a look at the next question. What is the payback period of the equipment? Well, if you're taking my class, what I'm going to be giving to you on your exam is I'm going to be giving you ratios. So the first one is the payback period, which is the cost of the investment, which is going to be 800,000 divided by the annual net cash flow of 241,000. So the payback period is going to be 3.31 years. So, or 3.32 years. Now, what's the problem with using the payback period? Well, if you saw the video that I did from problem one, and this is you're going through sequentially, you know that future dollars are not the same as today's dollars. And the problem is with both of these ratios, payback period and the accounting rate of return, they don't take into consideration the time value of money. Let's take a look at the accounting rate of return. The average annual after-tax net income for each year is going to be $91,000. My average capital investment is going to be my beginning book value, or $800,000, which is the cost of the equipment, plus my ending book value, which is going to be $50,000. Now, why is it $50,000? The ending book value, by definition, is salvage value. So coming over here, I divide that by 2. So this is going to be 850,000 divided by 2, or 425,000. So my accounting rate of return on this investment is going to be 91,000 divided by 425, or roughly 21.4%. Okay, so coming over here, the accounting rate of return, 21.4%. Now, one of the things you may have noticed is that the reason why I kind of go through that very, very quickly is because, again, in real life, the two that we just computed above are really not going to be used very much. However, the net present value is going to be used by us. So let's talk about computing net present value. So I have YO, or year zero, year one, year two, year three, year four, and year five. Why do we have 5 years? Well, aside from being a great David Bowie song, we have 5 years, dad joke for the day. It tells us that's how long the equipment will last for. So the year zero cash outflow is a negative 800,000. So what I have to go through and do is I have to figure out, well, what is my cash flow each year? So my cash flow each year is going to be 241,000. So that's how much it's generating every single year. So my net cash flow. Now, there's one other tricky thing to this question, is that at the end of the equipment's life, I should be able to go through and to sell the equipment. When I sell the equipment, I'm going to be able to sell it for salvage value. So my salvage value, or this $50,000, is what I'll be able to sell the equipment for at the end of year five. Okay, so as we've seen with these questions, right? So we've got, these are the future cash flows. Now we need to bring these back into today's dollars. And we're going to do that by using present value tables. Now, for the 241,000, the same amount is being paid every single year. So if you did the first question where we have the 27,000 every single year, This is something we call an annuity. So for us to go through and to bring this back into today's dollars, we're going to say the present value of an ordinary annuity of a dollar. And this is going to be 5 periods at 9%. Require a 9% rate of return on my investments. There we go. So the present value of an annuity, 5 periods at 9% is 3.88965. Why is it five? Well, we're basically being paid out five times. So over here, 5 periods at 9%, 3.88965. So the present value of these future cash payments coming out are going to be $937,406, or these future cash inflows. This is why I like net present value, because we're taking into account interest. Now, let's go through and look at the $50,000. So this is the annual cash flow. And this $50,000 here is going to be the salvage value. So for this one, it's a one-time payment. So we're going to go to the present value of a dollar. And for this one-time payment, what we're going to go through and do is say, well, this is being paid out in year five, or at the end of the asset's life. So this is going to be 5 periods at 9%. So I go here, the present value of a dollar, 5 periods at 9% is 0.64993. So 0.64993. The present value of this is going to be $32,497, present value of the salvage value. And when I add up the present value of the annual cash flows to the present value of the salvage value, you're going to get $969,902. However, that's not the droid we're looking for. We're looking for net present value. So what I need to do is my initial investment, and this is going to give me my net present value of this particular investment. So that's what we're going through and computing. So this is the net present value. If you're taking my class, this is by far going to be the most points in terms of your test. It's going to be basically computing the net present value, just because that tends to be like the harder part of the question. So and if you are taking my class, when it comes to the ratios, I will be providing you all of these ratios for your exam, because I don't believe that you should be memorizing these different types of ratios, because I make the class difficult enough in terms of the problems that I'm going through and creating. So I want to thank all of you for being with me here today. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking and subscribing. And I look forward to seeing you on future videos. Have a great day.